But I do like this idea because opening critical periods is one way to put it, like in PTSD. But here, let me put it this way. When you have a synaptogenesis at the time of a traumatic event, let's say, that sucker gets embedded into your amygdala and is very, very, very difficult to reverse for whatever reasons. That's a learning. I mean, I can forget my, certain things like, my American Express card number pretty easily, but maybe my Social Security number I don't forget. So there are certain things that are easy to forget. There's some things that are hard to forget. And so the issue is consolidation. Do you ever hear that term? Consolidation is the term for filing your memory when you first get it. So the memorable experience that you're having now and consolidation of any new memories that you're having is the first storage of a new memory. Then what happens is that your brain will then want to review the file. So it takes it out of memory and puts it into consciousness, and it has a mechanism to do that, to say, Stahl was full of crap, I'm gonna eliminate this thing, I'm gonna take it out of memory and erase it, or it was brilliant and it connects to 17 other things, so I'm gonna connect other memories to this memory so that it enriches this memory, and then it's called reconsolidated, it's refiled. And at least in animal models, the refiling of the memory is labile. It's easy to disrupt. You can disrupt it with a variety of drugs or with foot shock stress or other things so you don't file it. And guess what? You've just forgotten it. So ladies and gentlemen, whether or not I believe that you have to hallucinate, I do think it's interesting to think of the possibility of disrupting reconsolidation. That's a fancy way of saying, and this is my hope, you can forget your PTSD. You can forget your addiction. Your addiction is just a memory in an addicted circuit. In principle, why couldn't you?